Good morning, friends. I am joining you from the third floor of the New England Aquarium this morning, and I am in front of our beautiful Amazon reptile exhibit. Now, this exhibit shows off a lot of small, beautiful Amazon fish species, but this tank is a real fan favorite due to a particular animal in here, our green anaconda. This morning, we're gonna take you behind the scenes to get a glimpse at this exhibit from the other side of the glass, because believe it or not, there are three adult anacondas in this exhibit. So let's go see if we can find them. Okay, friends, I'd like to introduce you to my friend, Allison. Allison is one of our amazing animal care team, and typically she's spending most of her time taking care of the animals in our temperate gallery, but right now she's also helping out in our freshwater gallery. So Allison is standing right in front of a door, and Allison, maybe you could tell us what is behind this magical door this morning.
Yeah, so this is the back entrance to our anaconda exhibit. So there are hundreds of really cool Amazonian fish that live in this exhibit, but the stars of the show here are three green anacondas.
Awesome. What do you think? Can we maybe open up the door and take a peek?
We sure can, yeah. So awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and unlatch it here. Anacondas are very strong and they're also pretty curious. So we keep the door locked to make sure that they can't push it open.
So again, our visitors often are asking us, where are the anacondas hanging out in the exhibit? Because they're not always front and center when you're looking at them from the front of the tank. So Allison, maybe you could tell us and also maybe show us where the anacondas like to hang out.
Yeah, so if the anacondas are out basking on exhibit, there are two spots that they might be. The first spot is right up next to the viewing window of the exhibit at the front. And then the second spot is actually right under us here, right next to the back door. And then we also have our smallest anaconda, Anna, and her favorite spot, or one of her favorite spots to hang out, is to actually slither up to, I don't even kind of see it here, but slither up to the top of this, what's a fake termite mound, and hang out up there. So if you ever see an anaconda sitting up there, it's definitely Anna. But other than that, the anacondas actually spend a lot of their time in the water, and that's something they do in the wild as well. In the wild, they'll actually spend a lot of their time hanging out in the water, and that actually helps them thermoregulate. So they're what we call ectothermic poikilotherms, which is just a fancy way of saying that they need to use their environment to regulate their body temperature. So in the wild, they'll spend a lot of time in the water, and that'll help them kind of attain that perfect temperature. And it's the same thing here at the aquarium. So we keep their exhibit water nice and warm. So they like to spend a lot of their time hanging out in the water.
Could you maybe tell us a little bit about the life story of our three anacondas?
Yeah, sure. So our two older anacondas are Wilson and Marion. All three of our anacondas are females. But Wilson and Marion, two oldest ones, they're about 12 years old now. Marion is the largest, so she's about 13 feet from snout to tail. And she is about 77 pounds. And then Wilson comes in second, so she's about 12 feet and about 60 pounds. And then Anna's the smallest, so she's only 10 feet long, and then she is almost 60 pounds at this point.
Allison, you do a lot of work every day to help take care of these animals. Can you maybe tell us a little bit about what the care for adult anacondas involves?
One of the most important things with taking care of anacondas is providing them with an appropriate habitat. So that includes giving them clean water to hang out in, and also keeping the temperature of their tank what they like. So that, you know, is why we have heat lamps in the exhibit and their basking spots if they need to, if they choose to use them. And then other important things are providing them with a good diet, and then also giving them expert care. So anacondas in the wild don't eat every single day. They can actually go for weeks at a time without eating anything at all. Here at the aquarium, we feed our anacondas once a week. So we'll offer them a variety of food items that will mimic the food items that they might encounter in the wild. Their favorite are guinea pigs. And then in terms of the care that we give them also, we have to make sure that they have good veterinary care. So just like you or I might go to the doctor once a year for an annual physical, our anacondas actually also get an annual physical. So they come out of their exhibit and our veterinarians get to take a look at them, take their weight, get measurements on them, make sure that their scales look healthy, and they can even do radiographs and blood draws on them as well to make sure that everything in their body is really healthy looking.
Now, Allison, you have kind of already given it away by just kind of your general body language while the tank's been open, but do you ever get nervous working in an exhibit with three large snakes?
So, good question. I can see why people would think it's a little bit nerve-wracking to work with big predators like this. So the first thing to kind of remember and realize is that a lot of the stories that we hear about anacondas really exaggerate their predation habits. So in the wild, an anaconda very rarely ever comes into contact with a human. But that said, they are big animals, and so here we take a lot of precautions to make sure that our staff are safely interacting with these guys. And one of the really important things that we need to be able to do is we need to be able to read our animal's body language. So that includes taking cues from the anacondas to make sure that they're comfortable with anything that we're doing around them.
Now, it sounds like our anacondas have a pretty great life here at the aquarium. Excellent care, no predators, hand-delivered food. It's not a bad life. But anacondas out in the wild maybe face some different challenges than our anacondas here at the aquarium. In your opinion, what is probably the biggest challenge facing green anacondas in the Amazon?
So anacondas in the wild face a couple threats. So while they're not considered endangered in the wild, a couple of the threats that they face are common to other Amazonian animals, mainly deforestation and habitat loss due to that. And then the other thing that can threaten them in the wild is actually humans. So humans will hunt them, and that can either be out of fear or it can be for things like scales or their skins or their body parts, other body parts.
Awesome. So I think deforestation is something that probably people are pretty familiar with, but maybe might not be as familiar with what you can do about it from here in Massachusetts. So one thing that I like to tell our friends at home about is just being mindful about where your stuff comes from. A lot of deforestation in the Amazon comes from things like logging, so cutting down trees to make products such as paper, or for farming, growing things. Now, one of the biggest exports from South America is coffee, and I'm sure some of you are at home right now sipping a nice warm cup of coffee. So do a little research, find out where your coffee is coming from. They actually will grow coffee in the understory of the rainforest, which means you don't have to cut down any trees in order to get that delicious Brazilian coffee. So doing a little research about where your stuff comes from is a really easy way to help protect anacondas. All right, friends, I think that brings us to the end of our presentation this morning. I just want to thank you again, Allison, for showing us the back of this tank. I think this is something that probably most of us have never seen before. It's a really cool view. And now you know the next time you come to the aquarium where the anacondas are hanging out. So keep your eyes peeled for the back of the exhibit where our snakes like to bask underneath those light, nice heating lamps that Allison was mentioning. All right, friends, thank you for joining us today. Remember, if you have questions, put them in the comments. We will answer them for you. And we hope to see you back here tomorrow. Thanks. Bye.